In Europe, in a country, in a developed country like Netherlands, people are living like this, in the tent, on this cold weather. It is very awful. Without heat, without water, without toilet, it is very sad to see it. So we hope something better will come out from here.
We are living in the tents. Tents are for women and the men apart. Women are living in this tent, and the men are living in that tent. Two, three tents. And the small tents are here. And we are sleeping overnight here. And some of us have a bed. Small bed for one person, and we have a night sleep sleeping sheets and clothes and blankets, and we are sleeping here, and we do feel cold. So that the winter is coming, yes. So it's not comfortable really, but we don't have any option than sleeping here. Yeah, it's really shame to say like this.
They don't have toilet. They don't have the toilet. Is this and it is not enough? Yeah. They have to shower. When they want to shower, they have to go to the neighborhood here, and they have to ask the neighbors to give them shower, and they have to shower there. People are supporting them with the beds and mattresses and bed decks. They don't have anything, even the food what they are eating. At night, in the evening, they have to eat their dinner at the mosque here. They give them the warm food, and the people, the neighborhood are supporting them with tea, coffee, and food. Mm-hmm. It's like that. They don't have nothing yet.
No electric here, no gas.
I am sleeping in the bed in the rain. Mm-hmm. In the bed is all water. It's cold, very cold, no light, no shower, no clothes, no wash.
It is not their choice to be here, and it is not their choice to go back to their country, because both are impossible situations. And living like this in this tent is very unhuman.
I come from Eritrea. I live here 2 months. I sleep a strat. No place and no family. Mm-hmm. And I am sick. Mm-hmm. No solution.
Yeah, I'm here because I was living on the street, and I've asked asylum in 2009, Netherlands. But my asylum was not accepted, and after all, my procedure is closed, and I'm on the street, and I have no sleeping place, and I have no any house or clothes to eat something. So why I come here and living here? That's the reason. Soon my procedure is closed, and I have no option, and they take me to detention. And after the 6 months, they let me on the street, and then after that, the government has no giving me not any no any help. So I was living. I'm living on the street 1 year now. So organizations. Sometimes they help me. After 6 months, they set me again. They say, "Go out. We can't help you more." Sometimes I didn't get any solution or any protection. That's why I'm living here.
Go.
Almost 9, 10, 9, 6, 6.
home?
Absolutely, we cannot survive. Mm-hmm. We came from hot area. It's very extreme other weather condition. And this is very extreme cold weather condition. So it is another zone. So we cannot live like this. Even the people living in these countries are also feeling cold. But we what do you think? We ask government to give attention to our humanity and just accept our situation. Because this is not the solution to let somebody on the street a long time suffering like this. After all, we are also same like others, human beings. Yeah? So we have to have feeling to for each other. That's my stand. We want to have like normal person living permission. We want to have free to move like society. We want to involve in the society and living with the society. We have no any other target, just living as a society. We have no any further motivation. We escape from our country because of political problem, and we couldn't go back to our country. Still, our politicians are not good for us. We are opposing party. So they cannot cooperate us. So if we go back, we become tortured or detention or life imprisonment or death or permanent imprisonment. So this is a problem. So we prefer to stay here. We prefer to stay in the snow on the street in the winter than going back and suffering that problem.